يا ويحهم ماذا جنوا وتأفكوا وأتوا بقول الجاهل الفتان ورعيت منهم أرعنا يدعو إلى سحر.
الحمد لله على إحسانه والشكر له على توفيق وامتناني، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له تعظيم لشاني، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله داعي إلى رضواني. أما بعد، today I have a brother here who has been hit by سحر المشموم. Sihr al-Mashmoom is a black magic of sniffing. This brother, I request all of you watching to make dua for this brother, because this magic was meant for him to become crazy and to lose everything. And alhamdulillah, Allah has preserved him. He was about to go that level, but Allah has preserved him again, has protected him, and he is fine and he's gradually getting better. Sihr al-Mashmoom is black magic of sniffing. You sniff smoke, you sniff attar, you sniff anything that is in the air, you sniff, it goes inside your nose and it stays in the forehead, in the chest, and in the back. This brother has been hit by this magic for 2 years. He's been struggling. Alhamdulillah, he has met me for about 2 months now. I've been treating him and he's far, far better. You can hear from his own testimony, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Wa alaikum assalam.
How are you?
Alhamdulillah.
How is everything?
Getting a lot better now.
Alhamdulillah. When did your problem started?
Roughly about 2 years ago.
What happened? Explain to us what happened.
Just suddenly I used to really lose my temper, really get aggressive with a lot of people. Mm-hmm. One day I just lost it completely. You know, my mind started shaking. I just lost my mind. I ended up in hospital for 2 weeks. They said to me, I got mental disorder over depression, a lot of anxiety because of stress. I stayed in hospital for 2 weeks.
But did you think it was stress?
I genuinely believed maybe it was stress because I couldn't understand myself.
What was wrong with you?
What was wrong with me? Before that, I was a very, very active person. I used to always be able to do all the general activities, be outgoing, go to, do whatever I need to do.
Absolutely.
After I came back, I had a lot of anxiety. I couldn't go do my daily activities even. I used to be
someone who's locked.
Yeah, a lot of anxiety. I used to be feared to go to the shops. When I used to go to shops or, anywhere outside, my heart used to just start beating. I used to get really, really nervous. I had a lot of sleeping problems in the night. I used to always try and my mind used to be occupied. I used to get really, really busy in the night.
Okay, how was your mind occupied?
It's really busy, just general life stresses. Everything used to come into my mind.
Even though
I was trying to still
be stable.
Yeah, stable, but I used to have a lot of stress. And I used to have a business. Whenever I used to go to my business, I used to argue with people for no reason.
Even you used to argue with your workers?
Yeah, get rid of, sack them a lot and,
Sack them all?
Yeah, a lot of them for no reason. Sometimes just for no reason. And a lot of the time, my behavior, my attitude, I used to get really high-tempered so easily. Mm. Sometimes out of nothing, I'll shout at somebody.
Your workers?
Yeah, workers. Even friends,
how was
family.
Your business then? When you had all this happening, was your business going down or
no,
was booming?
It was booming. It was booming.
While you were still suffering.
It was very, very busy. I used to have 20 people working for me.
Alhamdulillah.
It was very, very good. I done very record business there.
Alhamdulillah. So while your business was booming, at the same time you were suffering.
Yeah, I was suffering.
Nobody knew.
Even myself, I could understand something's gone wrong with me. Mm. But I generally thought it's because of setting up the business, all the stress, maybe.
Of the people.
Yeah, or of the people, general stress in life. I thought maybe that was the reason. Mm. But sometimes I used to tell people, I don't know why I shouted. After I done the argument and shouting, I used to tell them, I'm sorry, I don't know why I did that.
I
can't understand.
That's the influence of magic, or influence of something.
Definitely.
You do actions and then in the end, you reflect and then regret.
No, definitely.
And that is a lot of people who've got problems, brother.
Definitely.
They do have this.
They don't realize though.
Yes,
they realize.
Absolutely.
They'll think it's stress or whatever it is.
It's an outside influence. Majority of the time is inside.
You'll understand because your life will be changed. You'll think, you'll have a lot of hatred towards people. People will start making
the
faces.
The one who will help you.
Yeah, you'll think that people are making faces at you. You'll think, no, nobody likes you. A lot of the people out there, everyone hates you for whatever reason. And that's not how it is. It's definitely something wrong with you. Luckily, I've been praying before I actually met yourself, Sheikh. Mm. I was praying a lot. I was sticking to my deen and stuff. And then suddenly, obviously, that day, what happened is them 3 days, I lost the plot completely. And then I start believing in jinns and everything.
Before and that, that's when they called me. And
yeah, definitely. And you seen me when you came. I wasn't still stable.
Absolutely.
Yeah, because absolutely. I would have been in the mental. They would have sectioned me. Oh, put me in the hospital. Yeah,
this is the point. You told me before they've already sectioned you, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
How was when they sectioned you?
They said to me they're gonna take me away because you know I couldn't. I never
you couldn't cope.
Yeah, I couldn't sleep for 3 days. I couldn't see nothing. I couldn't eat.
How long ago? You say it started 2 years. So how long ago? In these 2 years, after 4 months, 5 months, they sectioned you while your business was.
No, after 2 years, because I was still going to the hospital. Right. When I went to the hospital, when I was there, it's not a hospital, but just under the hospital, they treat you there for stress people or you know for people with mental health problems.
All right.
But when I was there, alhamdulillah, with the grace of Allah, I came out because they said to me, there's nothing wrong with you. You're just stressed out. But you know,
but in reality, there was something wrong with you.
Definitely. Because that wasn't me. Everyone was shocked that happened to me. Do you understand? They thought, well, what's going on? I thought maybe financial stress or whatever the reason is. But I couldn't get my energy back. You know, the energy I used to work before, only sleep 3-4 hours and be active from 7 o'clock in the morning all the way till 1-2 o'clock in the night. No one could stop me and my brain was very, very sharp. Very, very sharp. Yeah, I used to, you know, alhamdulillah, Allah, you know, blessed me with a lot of things. And I don't know what happened, obviously, after so long. Still, I thank Allah that He's brought it to light to me.
Absolutely true, yes.
Otherwise, I could have gone a long time without it.
Yeah, crazy. 100%. Crazy, yeah. And the mental hospital.
And generally, I used to always, you know, He was eating me away because, you know, I was just hating myself and not being able to complete my eyes to see wedding proposals is not being successful for me. I'm trying to apply for loan, like general loans and stuff in my life to sort out my problems. Nothing's being successful. It's all about to happen, but then something goes wrong. Generally, I don't know.
You had money, you had restaurant, you had a place to sleep, you had cars, you had everything. Yeah. But still, no one knew
that
there was something wrong with you. Only you knew.
I wasn't aware. Till I was thinking, if I say it to people, they're going to think I'm mental. So how can I disclose it to anybody?
Yeah, because you are afraid to say to people what's going on inside your head. That's what it is. Yes or no?
Definitely. Yeah. At night, in reality, it's to just make my mind so busy, but like my brain's going to pop.
Yeah, but in reality, you know, a lot of people go through this, brother. But people need to come forward.
No, definitely.
Yeah, people need to come forward and say, this is what I'm going through. You know, according to myself, and the sheikhs I know who deal with the spiritual problem, 90 to 70% of these mental health, because I've been to the mental health hospitals.
No, definitely.
It's to do with the spiritual problem.
No, 100%. Yeah. But most people won't believe in it. Because even I was sectioned and I've gone back. They said to me, there's nothing wrong with you. We haven't even sectioned you or anything. Because, you know, I said to them.
How long did you stay in the mental health hospital?
Five days.
5 days.
5 days, yeah. They were going to let me go. How many times? Just once I've been. But after the two years, I was going to be obviously end up there again. But generally, I thought because of lockdown, stress and everything, is maybe all this. But that's not the reason.
Yeah, absolutely true. That wasn't absolutely the reason. Now, tell me, while you were isolating yourself, what we used to do?
A lot of haram
Things. Haram stuff.
Yeah.
You get thoughts to do haram.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. Tell me this haram. What thoughts was it?
I got a lot of, you know, I used to do a lot of evil haram stuff. I want to go out, do haram.
And do you get thoughts of killing people?
No, nothing like that.
Just
no.
Thoughts of raping and things like that?
No, nothing like that. Just, you know, making...
Drinking alcohol, smoking cigarette.
Yeah, just no peace. No peace. Sometimes I just
watching pornography.
Yeah, most of the time he was trying to harm myself.
Commit suicide.
Commit suicide. Go away from this world.
Alright. So you're getting thoughts to commit suicide.
Yeah.
How often were these committing suicide thoughts come?
Every so often, every 4-5 months, sometimes. You know, just get general fed up with life. You know, general activity.
Yes.
You just don't want to live the general life. Just fed up.
But in reality, it wasn't you.
No, 100%. Not me.
And you never knew it was you.
No, because I was never like that. I couldn't decide why this happened to me.
Did you even one time sit down and say, what's happening to me? This is not me.
I did a few times.
All right. When was that?
Just a few times. Generally, I sat down and said, what's going on with me?
In these 2 years?
Yeah, a few times.
Yeah.
A few times I sat down
and
said.
What did you do after that?
I just tried to get myself better.
Did you make dua?
Definitely. I read namaz and I made dua.
To Allah to reveal, to show you what's
wrong. Show me what's wrong. Yeah. And I've been praying for a long time now, like at least six. I used to pray on and off, not my 5 times, but you know, Zuhr namaz, Asr namaz. I used to pray Isha namaz here and there. But yeah, you have to stick to five times. Never used to pray Fajr namaz, obviously. Yeah, that I used to be a missed.
Yeah, you have to pray five times.
Recently, I've been praying. Obviously, I've been sticking to my five namazes.
Alhamdulillah. Since I saw you, you've been sticking to your namazes.
And I've been praying to Allah as well. Show me what's wrong. Why doesn't my wedding happen? What's wrong? Because a lot of people, everything's about to happen and then it disappears or something goes wrong.
Yeah, this is black magic. This is serious black magic. You know, when they do black magic, they don't only do one. They do three, four, five. And it all triggers at one time. Or sometimes they only trigger one. Ask Allah to protect us and make it easy for you.
Inshallah.
Now, what was the purpose? What do you think from the bottom of your heart?
Purpose is definitely envy and jealousy. Definitely.
Because of your business, you're a businessman.
Business here. And because he was very, very successful. Mm. They all tried. They couldn't be successful in that place. Mm. And you know, obviously, they were after the business.
All right. Any advice will you tell the audience?
Have faith in this. Just really say, you know, exist out there. I never used to believe it. I used to pray myself as well. Yes. And I used to think, you know, if I read namaz here and there, yeah, what can anything attack me? But you have to follow
the Quran and sunnah
properly, yeah, to understand and, yeah, to be fully protected.
Yeah, absolutely.
Otherwise, true, you have to go to somebody with the experience to find out what's wrong with you.
Absolutely true.
And they will guide you in the right path.
Yeah, but there's definitely so many people out there.
Yeah, because you might think, you know, I read namaz, that's it, that's the end of it. But you have to do it according to the sunnah and the right way.
Absolutely.
For everything to, you know, come to light.
Absolutely.
Then you will do treatment yourself. Once you know the correct way, correct procedures, you can do a lot of things yourself and, yeah, you will be protected.
Yeah.
And then nothing, inshallah, nothing can harm you.
Alhamdulillah. And how are you since we met?
Alhamdulillah. Since the last 2 months, I've recovered a lot myself. You know, I've been sleeping peacefully.
Tell us, since the last 2 months and before that, what's the percentage you are now?
About, I'd say 90%.
Before?
Better, yeah.
Now?
Yeah, better now.
90% better.
Better, yeah. Because before I used to have problems. I used to pray namaz, but never used to go to the mosque. I used to have a lot of anxiety, even just generally going to the cheap shop, local shops. I used to avoid it, get everything delivered to my house. And avoid people, generally, even my family members. I thought if someone used to come to my house, I used to get anxiety. I never used to like anybody coming to my house. And I wasn't like that. I was a very, very sociable person before. I used to always invite all my family members, keep everyone together. I was like a leader of the family. And then last 2 years, I start hating people. People that are close to me, I used to always keep arguments with them, always try and argue with them for whatever reason. And then I used to always run away from them. If they used to come to the room, I used to go to another room. I used to always stay in my room alone. When people are coming to my house, I used to isolate myself. And then, you know, either, you know, watch movies, do whatever, or, you know, just keep myself busy. I was never like that. I wasn't outgoing. I kept myself isolated from my friends, everybody, even my work colleagues, everybody. I isolated myself. Before, I used to be like a group at work. Then I became like a boss. I wasn't mixing myself with anybody. I said, just go there, do my job, come back. There was at one point I used to walk in through the back. I don't know why Allah has guided me, but the magic was when I came back from the hospital, like the treatment center, the first time round.
The mental hospital.
Yeah, I used to come back. It wasn't the mental hospital. It's like a section just underneath the mental hospital.
Right.
They treat you there. If you don't recover from there, then you end up in the mental hospital.
All right, okay.
Yeah, that's how it is.
So you used to go from your walking place, go from the back door.
Yeah, back door.
You hide yourself from the
black. Yeah, because the black magic was in the front. Yeah, because I was afraid. And before I used to feed 120, 30 customers every single day. You know, I was front of house.
Well, why do you used to go from the back door? Were you afraid of the
workers? Yeah, I just got anxiety suddenly. Before, for many years, I used to work in the front of house, you know, have the charm, speak to customers, speak to all different kinds of people, you know, manage the 20 people. Nobody could say anything. I was very, very confident person, very, very jolly person, and, you know, mixed with everybody, being nice to everybody. But after that, when I came back, I couldn't work in the front anymore. I have been working in the back of the house for 2 years. I was never a back of house worker, but I managed myself. I just let go of everything.
You're also afraid to go from the front, you go from the back door.
Yeah, that was just, I think that was just, you know, blessing from Allah, because no one told me it was black magic or anything. But no, even at the time I used to read namaz, maybe Allah guided me to
it was the black magic, because we discovered the black magic.
Yeah, but I used to avoid it, because, yes, you know, when I used to walk in through the front, I told my brother, family members and brothers, and the work colleague, when I used to walk in through the front, that night I used to have a very aggressive night with everybody. Everyone, I'll shout at somebody. And when I've been working for 3 months, I walked in through the back. When I used to do that, I'll be peaceful, not argue with anybody, just carry on working. But otherwise, I won't let people work as well. And because it was a busy place, every day, a lot of people coming, it is very, very difficult if you don't operate. You need to have the operating procedures in place.
Absolutely true.
Especially food business, you know, customers come in, the food needs to go out, it needs to be prepared. And when it's quite popular, you need to have everything prepared as well. It's important with the quality. It's very important. But alhamdulillah, how I feel now is, you know, I feel the full energy again now. I can, you know, start life again and, you know, do whatever I want. Obviously, I have a bit of disturbance still. But, you know, I'm looking, inshallah.
Of course, you'll get over it.
Inshallah, get over it, because with time.
Listen, 90% recovery.
Alhamdulillah.
10%, it was just few minutes back, your brain could have been what? Gone, isn't it?
But them 3 days, I was literally, my brain was going.
Going, yes.
But I had faith in Allah. Yeah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you know.
Yeah.
And luckily, He's guided me and we met you at the right time as well.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Now tell us about this, your business. You used to go from the back door.
Yeah, there's like an alleyway.
But you used to be afraid from the front door, or whenever you go inside.
I just used to get anxiety and I don't know when for whatever. From the front door. Because obviously the magic was placed by the front door.
Front door, yes.
When but for whatever reason, when I went through the front door, I realized that when I go walking through the front door, I have a lot of problems waking that night. I used to be very aggressive for no reason, like argue with people, you know, probably mistreat people as well. Because it was a busy place. I don't know what. It used to be very aggressive.
So you ran away from this, hiding yourself in the back.
Yeah, hiding myself in
from
the back.
From your own business.
Yeah, definitely.
Alhamdulillah. And then we came there. We discovered the magic was done in the front door.
Definitely.
Yeah. This is how the people do.
Yeah, that's by the counter where I used to stand, greet all the customers. Because I used to be the host of the restaurant.
All right.
Because obviously it's a big job trying to manage, you know, obviously I have 20 people in my team and then 120 customers sitting down, 140 people on a daily basis. Sometimes, you know, I'm having two turnarounds or, you know, 200 people coming through the door and walking out, making sure the food goes out. Limited hours is a very difficult job.
Absolutely.
Operating procedures, you know, making sure everyone's doing their job right.
Absolutely.
And everything's just operating.
Absolutely.
It's a tough job.
Absolutely true.
And I was doing it eyes closed.
Yeah.
Until I ended up in hospital. And after that, I just couldn't do it. I had to, you know, get my family members, everyone to help me. You know, the business dropped a lot since then. It's gone downhill since then. But I just left it. I wasn't bothered.
Of course, if there's no leader, there's no leader.
It's very difficult.
Yes.
But before, no one could stop me from I used to always be like, you know, sharp, very, very sharp. Catch anything that goes wrong. And had the energy. But after that, after the 2 years, I used to sleep a lot of hours. I just feel really drowsy. But when I go to bed, I can't sleep. Just lazy. A lot of body pains
as
well.
What about when you go to your business? How do you used to feel? Apart from going from the front door. When you go from the back door, how do you used to feel?
Back door, I'm okay. But even in the kitchen, I was still calm. But sometimes I used to get aggressive, very aggressive.
From the back door?
Yeah. Even like, you know, with the team members or anybody, get aggressive for no reason. Yeah. Just make an excuse to fight with people.
Now, when you go from the front door, what do you used to do?
Be aggressive.
And tell us about the aggression.
Just suddenly I'll start shouting or speaking rudely to people. Swears used to come out of my mouth as well. That I've never been like that. Or, you know, I'll start arguing for no reason. Or I'll get aggressive, very hot-tempered, and then I'll walk out.
People wanted your business.
I think maybe that's what the reason was. People wanted the business.
What do you think yourself? What was the purpose?
I think definitely, obviously, the business and jealousy, envy.
Of course, jealousy.
Just envy. Just, you know, they're not good people. That's the bottom line. And obviously, whoever does this, they are off the fold of Islam.
Absolutely.
Allah will punish them.
That's absolutely true. Absolutely. Unless they repent. They repent. People do bad things to people.
But if they repent, they have to get punished for this. I've never done anything to them, brother.
I'll tell you a story. I had a story of a brother. This is a Somali brother. He used to live in the West. Okay? What he used to do is he used to send money to his brother. Before sending money, what he used to do is he used to pile his money until it became a big chunk. And then he called his brother and said, "Brother, I need you to buy for me a house." He said, "Okay, let me go and check in the market." He went and checked in the market and he sent the pictures for him and said, "There's a house, this one, send this amount." His brother sent the money. He took the money, the brother took the money and went and marry and open his business for himself. And every time there is profit, he used to send money to his brother. And they tell him, "Oh, my brother, this is the profit from your house." But in fact, there was a shadow house. There was no house. And then the brother gather more money and send money to him and say, "Buy for me another house." He took it, marry another woman and expand his business. And every time there's a profit, he used to send it to him. He said, this is the money from your rent, the rent of your house. The brother keep on doing that. And then after that, he took some money again, send it to him and say, buy for me a car. He took the money and he took fake pictures of cars in the road. Say, this is your car. I've got it already. It's running. People are renting it. Huh? Look at that. Look at how people are. Yes. And then he sent a little bit of money to encourage him. Now the brother said, from nowhere, he just told him, brother, tonight I'm flying, I'm coming to you. Tonight I'm flying, I'm coming to check my houses and check my business and my cars.
Yeah.
And I'm thinking to settle down. I don't want to stay in the West.
Yeah, yeah.
His brother went mad. He said, don't come tonight, don't come. He said, no, I've already cut the ticket, I'm coming. The first time, he said, don't come. The brother delayed. The second time, he delayed. The third time, he says, oh, it's too late. I've already caught the ticket. I'm
coming.
Coming. His brother, he didn't sleep the whole night. He was thinking, what do I need to do? What do I need to do? Because I don't have anything. Everything I was sending was shadow. I was benefiting, profiting. He had the money he was sending. He opened, he had a massive supermarket because of the money of his brother.
His brother, yeah.
And he had four wives.
Four wives as well.
He married four wives because of the money of his
brother.
He wasn't honest. So he sat and think. And his idea came to his head. Shaitan brought idea to his head to kill him. He went and bought a gun. His brother landed. He went and took him. And he took him to the house and told him, eat his babies. His brother said, no. I need to see my cars. He said, listen, your cars are all been rented. But your house also has been rented. So we need to give in a notice to the people to go to. These are all lies. So the brother say, even if it's that, I need to go and see it. Even from outside. I need to just go and see it. There's no house. What is he going to show him?
Yeah.
There's no cars. What is he going to
show him? Yeah. There's nothing.
He say, okay, let's go. He traveled until where there is no person and no cars in the bush. And he told him, wait for me here, I'm coming. He went in the middle of the bush and sat for a while until his brother got worried, start looking for him. And he went in the middle of the bush looking for him. He would go cross. Now his brother saw him and he hid himself. When his brother passed, he took the gun and he wanted to shoot him. Wallahi by Allah, the gun did not trigger. His brother started sweating. He sweat. And then he hid the gun. He told his brother, let's go. They went back in the car. And I told him, let me speak to the people now. He come out from the car and he went for a little bit of distance. And he stand there and start. In his mind, something came into his mind. There is a man who is his neighbor, who is very qualified in helping people. He called the man. He said, I need your help now. Do whatever it takes. Let's help me now. He said, okay, I'm going to give you such amount of money. Just help me. What do you need from me? He said, I need this. He mentioned to him all. And then he told, okay, I'm coming now. He took his brother, because he's already in the evening late now. He took his brother. He told him, brother, stay in this house, stay in this room, in his own house.
Yeah.
Stay here, chill, go and shower. His brother went to shower because his brother now he's tired. He went, took him round, lying to him.
Yeah.
And his brother went to shower and he relaxed. He took his clothes off. He went to bed and to sleep. He took his clothes, the clothes of his brother, and went to the man who had agreement. And the man did whatever he did. He told him, what do I need to do to him? What do I do to him? Told him, make him crazy.
That's what they do, a lot of the people.
Yes. So the magician did whatever he did. And the person he was speaking to was a magician. So magician did whatever he did, and he gave him some powder. And he went to the house. While his brother sleeping, he touched the powder in the body of the brother, and the brother jumped. He became crazy. Until today, the brother is crazy. The guy confesses and says, I'm afraid. I can help my brother to become normal, but I'm afraid because I have eaten all his wealth.
Yeah.
The guy repented, but he's afraid to cure his crazy brother. Where did he get the wealth? From his own
brother. But the guy gone crazy overnight.
Of course. Straight away. Because Allah has decreed for him to be like that.
You can't do anything. No treatment.
So the brother repented, but he says, I'm afraid to help my brother. I know it's been my fault that I did this damage to my brother. This damage, I know it's my fault, but I'm afraid to help him because he's going to remember all his money and everything. And I don't know where to get the money because it's big money.
Spent all of it.
And he had a massive supermarket now. This is the level of the dunya.
Oh, definitely.
Brothers killing brothers, sisters killing sisters, mom killing daughters, daughters killing mom, auntie killing daughters. That's the circle.
That's
the circle. So we have to be very, very careful. We have to be very careful by staying closer to the Quran and Sunnah and asking Allah to protect.
If you obviously pray and stick to the namaz and the sunnah, you're protected.
Absolutely true. Absolutely
very hot,
true.
Lord, how many brothers and sisters out there are doing that?
Of course. And there are how many brothers and sisters out there? I'm crazy.
A lot of people.
Yes.
Or mental stress, just mental problems.
Yes.
Or general changes in your life, or something's not working out.
I have so many cases I can go on and mention.
Yeah,
or people who go mad, either from their mom or from their whatever.
Yeah, people, it's tough.
It's very, very crazy. Very crazy. General, how are you anyway? You've recovered all the way this?
Yeah, alhamdulillah, I'm a lot better now.
Alhamdulillah.
You know, I feel a lot better within myself.
Alhamdulillah.
And when I'm getting attacked or anything, I know now. I'm in control now.
Mm.
Whereas before, I never used to know.
Alhamdulillah.
Used to just take charge and let me do bad things or get me, you know, depressed or get me more stressed out, make me cause arguments with people around me. That's like my mother, my family, or if I'm at work, my team members, if I'm with my friends, against my friends, if I'm with my partner. It just wasn't me. I never had peace, never at peace. Something is always there. Even when I used to sit sometimes, I couldn't sit still. Something, I used to always either vibrate my hand or vibrate my fingers or vibrate my leg. I could never sit peacefully. That's another symptom as well. You can't sit peacefully anyway.
Mm.
And your heart starts beating really, really fast.
Mm.
Your heart starts, when you go in shops or anywhere you want to go, your heart starts beating, pumping really, really fast. I wasn't bothered about the business, bothered about anything. I lost interest in life activities, general. Mm. Lost interest in everything. Whereas that's not life. That wasn't me. Because it's definitely, and then it comes to a time when it just, obviously, it just reacts and tries to make you mental.
Mm.
But I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, you know, He's showed it to me. And
Alhamdulillah. I request all of you, the viewers,
please do dua for
me. Do dua for this brother. Alhamdulillah, like he said, now he has recovered 90%. Inshallah, by the will of Allah, Allah will help him.
Inshallah.
Ask Allah to cure you and to cure all those brothers who've got problems out there. Ask Allah to protect you and protect
all of us,
all the brothers and sisters, muwahidun, the one who rely upon Allah. وَمَنْ يَتَقِ اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَهُ مَخْرَجًا. Whoever fears Allah, Allah opens his ways and doors for him. It's a verse in the Quran. The fearing of Allah is very, very important. Allah mention again, يَا أَيُّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَنْتَقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا. O you who believe, if you fear Allah, Allah will show you the truth. So fearing Allah is very, very important, brothers and sisters. My brother, fearing Allah is very important. Allah shows you the truth. What is your problem? And then from there, you know, definitely.
100%.
You know, this is my problem.
Definitely.
Yeah. No, a lot of people lack this.
No, they won't pray. You need to pray.
No, the fear of Allah. Because when you have the fear of Allah, then you start doing what? Praying.
Everything is taken to the God.
But if you don't fear Allah, you will not pray. So when you have the fear of Allah and the conscience of Allah, Allah will protect you.
But there's two options, any. Either go to the mental hospital, live your life there, or, you know, fight it by the original truth.
Of course. Most
powerful person.
Of course.
Allah
Rabbul Izzah.
Sorry, I'm saying person.
The most powerful entity.
My mistake.
Yeah, the most powerful entity.
Yeah.
The one who created everything. Yes. Whether you are got magic of mental health.
Yeah, everything. And it disappears overnight.
Yes.
Overnight.
Over a second.
Overnight.
Yeah.
Overnight.
Yeah, over a second. It's just a flip of a coin.
Alhamdulillah.
And then that's it. You're either in the darkness or in the light.
Allahu Akbar. Allah is the greatest.
You're either in the dark or in the night. That's how it is.
Yeah, but when you come to see me, remember I was saying, I shit myself. I got really scared. The thing inside me got really scared.
Yeah, I came and saw you.
Yeah, I wasn't myself. Because after not sleeping for 3 days or anything, but, you know, from the next day, I became very, very good.
Yeah, because I read on you for about some time. And then I recommended you come in and see me again.
Yeah, definitely.
And alhamdulillah, you've improved a lot. Because the first time I saw you, you didn't know what you're saying.
Yeah, 100%.
Yeah, you were just totally somebody who is...
I was half crazy.
Yes, half crazy. Absolutely true. That's the word.
It's half crazy. Yeah. And I was saying stupid stuff to everybody.
Yes. Alhamdulillah. May Allah preserve you. Advice to the viewers.
If you experience anything like this and you think maybe it's not that, there's no harm in getting yourself checked out from
absolutely
the right
true.
person. you know, because with the will of Allah, it'll come to light for you. And these things do exist. I used to pray and stuff, but I never used to believe in. I used to think I pray namaz, I hear pray jummah, I pray 2-3 times a day here and there. So I'm protected. It doesn't work like that. You have to follow 100% to be fully protected. And these evil things happen, you'll be surprised on who can actually do it to you for whatever reason.
Let me tell you something. Allah says in the Quran, again, in Surah Al-Ma'idah, verse number 1, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا أوفوا بالعقود all you who believe hold tight to your contract. You know when you say لا إله إلا الله,
yeah,
it's a contract. This contract you need to establish or implement this contract fully, not partial, not
partial,
partial.
Yeah,
you have to be fully submit to this contract, meaning pray 5 times, giving zakat, siyam. You have to follow all the conditions of this La ilaha illallah.
100%.
Yeah, it has a condition, and this condition needs to be followed. Example now, if you have a mobile contract, okay, you've taken this contract, and if you don't pay, what will happen? It will be chopped off, isn't it?
Yeah.
And you'll start having bailiffs and people coming to. Exactly, this contract is exactly the same. The contract of La ilaha illallah. If you're not taking it serious, you'll find it where? On the day of judgment.
And in this life.
Of course, you'll live a very, very difficult life in this life. Allah says the same. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِ فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةُ ضَنْكَ. Whoever stays away from my remembrance, he will live a very difficult life.
Depressed life, yeah.
Yes.
Stressful.
So praying is very, very important. It will protect one. It will enlighten one. You will fear Allah. And Allah will, if there's any problem with you, Allah will show you the truth.
And you'll have peace.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
That's the main thing, you'll have peace. No matter what the situation is, wherever you are, you will be at peace.
Absolutely true. Absolutely true. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه فإنه هو الغفور